Hello again. Now we are gonna attack another problem, in this case problem number 68, which is named Capricorn Steps. And the statement says, the number 6174 is the Capricorn constant, and natural numbers less than 10,000, except some with 10 digits, can be reduced to 6174 in the following steps. Order the digits of the number in descending and ascending order and compute the difference. Repeat the process until you get 6174. And the example is as follows. We have, for example, n, which is 2376, and the digits in descending order is 7632. In ascending order are 2367. The first step is subtract and we get the difference. And then with this number, what we do is again order it. So we order it on descending order and ascending order. So after we get the two numbers, we also subtract those values and get another answer. And then we repeat the steps again. In this case, we get those two numbers, and when they are subtracted, we get this one. And we keep going until the final step, which is when you get the answer, which is 6174. In this case, there are 5 steps because you did this 5 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Yeah. That's the algorithm. What they are asking on it is your function should return the number of Capricorn steps for a given input. Numbers such as 2,222 will end in 0. These numbers will never result in 6,174, and they should return infinity as the final answer. So, okay, let's try it. Let's try to make it on code, and let's see how it goes. Okay, so we already got the code. It was interesting because there are many ways to work with this, and I decided to work with the numbers. I have seen maybe some fishy or obscure ways with making the numbers and string, writing like letters and then ordering in a much simpler way. But I decided to work with the numbers as they are, getting the number of digits and then a separate code for descending and ascending order with vectors. So the code is here. It is actually quite long because it doesn't fit in just one screen. But yeah, let's see how it works, and let's do it on MATLAB. In this case, we have the function which is called Capricorn Steps. The answer is y, and we start with y equals to 0. So I just giving this value for the sake of getting something for y. Sometimes it's not required. But yeah, I just decided just to be sure. That's because on our final answer, we also gonna have this one. And yeah, y is the number of steps. So each time a step is happening, we are adding 1 to that because it's the number of steps. So we are making a while command, and this ends when the final answer is 6174. Because that's what the statement says, and we say that b is gonna be the input is x, and then I just do this because I want to work with b, but I don't want to change the input. So maybe in the future you have to work again with the input, and it will be harder to do it if you have maybe make some random multiplication, maybe adding some number, or just working with that in any way. So that's why I'm using another variable that has the same value. Also, I get an empty vector, which is a in this case, and I say that the counter is 0. This first part is to get the number of digits of our input. So while b is bigger or equal to 1, what we are doing is getting the mod of the number and 10. So for example, if we have 25, the mod will be 5, and then we divide the value. So let me show that with an example, just to make sure that it's easy to understand. So we have this part of the code, and for example, I'm not sure, I said 25 will maybe work with something like this. And C on the first step is gonna be 4, because it's the mod of 28, 34 and 10. And in this case, when you divide, let me check this, 28, 34 over 10, you are gonna get 283.4. And yeah, the mod is gonna be 4, so that's the first value that we get. And then on the matrix, first the matrix was empty, and now the matrix is gonna have the first value, which is 4. That's what it says. Then B is gonna become the floor of B over 10. So since B over 10 is this, the floor is just the floor function is gonna be this one without the decimals. We are just rounding down the value, taking out any decimal. And yeah, we repeat this again and again. We have a conditional on the case that there is a specific value, but in this case it doesn't matter. We just do this again. So C is gonna be the mod of this, and since we know that 283 over 10 is 28.3, then C is gonna be 3, and then A is gonna become 4, because that was previously added, and then now 3, and then B again becomes 28. Remember that B became 203 here, and yeah, we can say B, we can say this is B, and we repeat and repeat. So in the end, what we are gonna get is A having 4, 3, 8 and 2 as our final answer, and the length of A is gonna be the number of digits that we have. On the case that we have a number like 1,100 or 10 or even 1, we have this little part of the algorithm that avoid that we end up on an infinite cycle or an infinite loop. So on the case of that happens, we change B to 0 just because of this part, and then we say that counter is counter plus 1. Counter is just the number of digits that the number have. And that's why counter is here also. And yeah, that's it. That's the first part of the code. It's actually just to get the number of digits of any number. Then okay, there are cases. Let me add this. There are also cases when we are not working with a 4-digit number. In those cases, for example, I don't know, 1, 2, 3. The final vector of the first part of the algorithm is going to be something like this. When that happens, we need to add another 0, because we are going to work with numbers of 4 digits. So yeah, 1, 2, 3 actually is understood as 0, 1, 2, 3, and we have to order those with that in mind. So those two values will be 3, 2, 1, 0 and 0, 1, 2, 3, and that will be the numbers that are going to be subtracted on the step. So this works for numbers that have only 3 digits, 2 digits, 1 digit, etc. So finally, what we do is Sword 8. So if they are not on ascending order with Sword 8, we get those. So for example, A equals Sword 8. Now A is gonna have, for example, in that case, 2, 3, 4, A. That's it. We are just getting on a certain order by just one command, which is sort. And also we need another vector, for example B, that has in on the sending order. Since I don't know any command for that, I just make a little part of the algorithm, which is for I equals 1 to the length of A. We do this. That is just basically inverting the order of the values of the vector A. How do we do this? Just by this little part. So the length of A is 4, plus 1 is 5, minus 1 is 4. So the first value of B is going to be the 4 value of A. The second value of B is going to be 4 plus 1 minus 2, 3. So the second value of B is going to be the third value of A. So the first value of A, sorry, the 4 value of A is going to be the first value of B. The second value of B is going to be the third value of A. The third value of B is going to be the second value of A. And the fourth value of B is going to be the first value of A. That was this little bar means. And finally, we just construct the number based on the vectors that we have, since these vectors are not numbers. And we need to convert them to numbers to be able to subtract those. That's why we are making this part. We are just getting a transformation from vectors and digits to numbers. Yeah, it's not that hard. And finally, we just make the subtraction. And that's the first step. That's why we, after this, say that y is equal to y plus 1. And a step has already been made. On the case we have, on the rare occurrence that we have numbers like 2,222 or maybe like 9,999, when we get the other number, we're just gonna have 0. And if this happens, which is kind of a problem, we need to return an answer which is gonna be infinite. So y is gonna be infinite. And then we say that we break the loop. So when we add break, we are out of this while, from this while part, sorry. We get out, and y is not gonna become nothing else because it's infinite already, and it stay at infinite. And that's the all the code. You can see here that is the same as here, just that it's in MATLAB. And also we have the draft, and we can try with any number. So for example, 1, 2, 3, 4, and let's show the answer. So for that we get 3 as the final answer. Maybe like, I don't know, let's take any random number, and we get just 2 steps. Okay, maybe 7, 7, 7, 7. On this case it's at 0, but it's actually infinite. So maybe on this trap I haven't made that change. Yes, that's why it's like that. Yeah, as easy as that. You can correct the code, make some corrections just to be sure that what you are doing is correct. On this case, for this number, we have 7 steps of the Kadrikak number. So okay, it's interesting. I actually like the code, and we can also show some of the tests. Like for this number we get 5 steps, for this other number which is 3 we get 6 steps, and other number of steps, infinite for this case. So yeah, we can also show the step by step part, maybe showing some of the answers here. can, for example, show these two numbers. And let's see. For the first step, we get this number and this number. The subtraction is this one. And then again, we get two numbers. And the subtraction is this one. We already get two steps. And we can do this as long as it goes. And yeah, it can also show this very easily. And the number of steps, on this case, is 7. You can also make a 4, like maybe some kind of 4, I equals 1, true, I equals 9,999. And let's show which value has the biggest number of steps. It can also be doable, although it's a bit more complex of an algorithm. And yeah, that's it. Thank you a lot for your attention, and yeah. If you want any problem to be solved, or maybe some questions, be sure to ask. We're here to help. And that's it. Thank you.